Father John po, SDB, we are now in the 6th Sunday in Ordinary Time. And today is February 14 and we are now celebrating Valentine's Day, Hearts Day. At ang ganda po para pong tumaiming po ang ating mga babasahin, ating first reading, second reading, ang ating gospel for this celebration. Because at this reading sa ating mga babasahin, we are being taught of or being reminded of what Christian love is. Kung paano ba tayo dapat talagang magmahal, kung ano ba ang tamang paraan na pagmamahal. Kung kaya nga po, gusto ko po simulan yung sharing ko ngayon using the second reading taken from the first letter to Corinthians, no? Chapter 10. In this particular letter, maribabasa din po natin dito yung description of Saint Paul about love. But at this moment, we are being focused on the intention of loving. What is the intention of love? Whatever you do, everything for the greater glory of God. Avoid giving offenses, not seeking your own benefit. Diretso po yung explanation dito. When we are loving, hindi natin iniisip ang ating sarili lang. Iniisip din po natin ang ating kapwa. Remember that the Ten Commandments is an expression of our love. Tinuturuan po tayo kung paano magmahal. When we are loving others, God, and our neighbors, our brothers and sisters, and is our expression of loving God. Therefore, when you are doing something, isipin mo, ito ba'y ginagawa ko lang para sa aking sarili o para sa kabutihan din ng aking kapwa? Kasi para po sa atin, if we do things or loving other people for our own benefits, we are not loving them. We are using them for our own joy. Kung kaya nga po, pinapaalala po sa atin ngayon, go deeper into your intention why you are doing these things. Why are you caring for this person? Why are you doing these particular things? Go to the intention of your heart. And I hope it is not all about you. It's also about the other's sake. Tinitignan din po natin ang kaligayahan at kabutihan ng ating kapwa. Hindi lang po ng ating sarili. Kung kaya nga po sa first reading taken from the book of Leviticus, pinapakita po dito, kapag nagkaroon po ng ketong sakit ang isang tao, anong gagawin niya? Anong gagawin ng simbahan? Anong gagawin ng komunidad? And here is the law that's being given to them. Kapag nagkaroon po ng sakit, nagkaroon po ng ketong, that person will be separated from the community. And that particular person will do everything what is required by the law. The intention is for the good of all. Siyempre, may sakit. Hindi nila alam how are going to cure it. At para sa kabutihan ng lahat, they have made a decision of how are they going to protect each other. Katulad po na nangyayari ngayon in our pandemic moments, sa ating mga sitwasyon ngayon, we are doing it not to seclude other people, not to judge other people, but for the good of all. Ginagawa po natin ito with a good intention. Yung intention po natin, kabutihan ng lahat. Not to judge them as we might think na nangyayari sa ating first reading. Dahil na nagkasakit, he is being punished by God? No. But they are doing it for the good of all. Kung kaya nga po sa ating pagbasa, sa ating gospel for today, taken from the Gospel of Mark, chapter 1, verse 40 to 45, pinapakita po dito, loving is a choice. Lumapit po isang ketongin kay Lord, "Lord, if you will, you can make me clean." And the Lord answered, "I will it." Pinapakita po sa ating celebration ngayon in the 6th Sunday in Ordinary Time, my dear friends, is the will to love. We have the choice, we have the power to love or to hate, to forgive or not to forgive. And loving, as what I have said, is a choice, a power given to us by God. But as we do these things, as we choose to love, let us always remember to think for the sake of others, not only of our own good. That is a Christian love. Because if we only think about ourselves, we might be exploiting other people for our own benefits. And that is the reminder that is being told to us now. Let us not use each other for our own benefits. But let's do this out of our love of God, out of our love of our neighbors. And everything that we are doing is for the greater glory of all. That's why when we love, as is being said in our second reading, love, imitate Christ. Imitate Him. Unconditional love. Ready to sacrifice even His own life for the good of all. So as we celebrate this Valentine's Day, today, February 14, let us fix our eyes to the examples of Christ who choose not to judge, who choose to love, who choose to give, who choose to help others, not thinking of Himself alone. So as we celebrate this day, let us ask for the grace for us to be able to imitate Jesus and to love in a Christian way, unconditional love, not thinking of our own, but also thinking for others. Once again, my dear friends, Happy Valentine's Day, and God bless us all.